Do like and subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update. In this video, I'll show you how to use MazerZoom command in AutoCAD. So, I have prepared this video on request of one of my viewer. So, let's get started. So, MazerZoom command is used to measure the distance between two points. Okay. So, I'll show you with an example. So, first, check line command. So, L enter. Shortcut key of line command L. L enter. Now specify first point here and second point here. Okay. Now I'll draw another line here with 15 feet, 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. Okay. 15 feet, 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. So take line command again. L enter. Now specify first point here. Click here. Now press the add button. Add. Now specify length 15 feet. Now press the less than key. Less than. Now specify the degree 60. Then for degree specify D. Okay. Now 10 minute. For minute single quote and 5 seconds. For second double quote. Okay. So add 15 feet, then less than key 60 degree, for degree specify D, at 15 feet and 60 degree 10 minutes. Okay, for minute single quote and 5 seconds, for seconds double quote. Okay, so 15 feet, 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. Okay, now press enter. Now see, this is 10. Now this line is created with angle. Okay. Now I'll check. Go to dimension. Aligned. Click here. Make ortho off. Again click here. Now this is 15 feet. Okay. Now I'll check the angle. So go to dimension. Angular. Now click on this line. Again click on this line. Now see, this is 60 degree. But we need degree, minute and second. Okay, we require this degree, minute and second. Okay, so here we'll use MazerZoom command. Okay, so for MazerZoom command, you can type MazerZoom enter. Okay, enter. Now see here, distance, radius, angle, area, volume. Okay, you can select from here also. Okay, you can, for distance press D or select distance, click here and click here. Now see, this is 15 feet. Okay, now click on angle. Okay, for angle again take MazerZoom command. Okay, for distance you can type D, enter, then click here and click here. Okay, so you can select from here and also type this D for distance. Okay, now I'll check the angle. Okay, for angle press A, enter. Now click here, click on this line, again click on this line. Now see, this is 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. Now you can see, this is 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. Okay. Now go to angular, click here and click here. See, this is only 60 degree. But if you need, go to MazerZoom, click here, angle. Click on this line, again click on this line. See, this is 60 degree, 10 minute and 5 seconds. Okay, so this is the MazerZoom command. Okay, now again MazerZoom command. Okay, now suppose I'll check the area. Okay, I'll check the area. Alright, so for area, click on area. Okay, now this is the first point, this is second point, this is third point. Again, close this here, enter. Now see, this is the area. 4528 square inch, 31.45 square feet. In perimeter, 33 feet, 1 inch. Okay, so you can check the area like this also. Alright, so now go to tools, workspaces. Now click on 2D drafting and annotation. Okay, now here this is the measuring command icon. Okay, you can also select the measuring command from here. Okay, by clicking here on measure. See here, distance, radius, angle, area, volume. So you can select from here also. Okay, so click here. Now first point here and second point here, this is distance. Now click on angle, click on angle. Now click on this line, again click on this line. Now see, this is the angle, 60 degree, 10 meter, 5 seconds. Okay, now click on area, then click here, this is the first point, click here, second point, click here, third point. Now close this here, enter. Now see, this is the area, 4528 square inch, 31.45 square feet, and perimeter 31 feet, 1 inch. Okay, so hope you understand how to use measuring command. Okay, now click here. Suppose I'll click on distance. Now click here and click here. Okay, then for angle, click here and click on this line. This is the angle. Okay, length and angle. So hope you understand how to use. Now suppose draw a circle. Okay, so this is circle. Now measuring command. Now I'll check radius. Okay, sorry, for radius, yeah, click here, click here. Now see, this is 7 feet and 10 inch radius. Okay, radius is 7 feet and 10 inch. Now click on angle. Now click here. Now see, these are the various angles. Okay, you can see, you can measure any angle. Okay, so hope you understand. All right, so now click here. Okay, this is radius 7 feet 10 inch. Now click on area. Okay, now click inside. Okay, now click here. Now again click here, click here, click here, click here. I'll calculate this much area. Okay, so this is, see, 6642 square inch and 46.12 square feet. Okay, so we understand how to calculate. You can calculate area as per your requirement. Okay, now go to measure. Now click on area. Okay, now here we need to calculate the complete circle's area. So for object, O, enter. We need to select object, O, enter. Okay, now click on object, click on circle. Now see, complete circle is selected now. Okay, now this is the area, 27644 square inch, 191.97 square feet, and circumference is 49 feet 1 inch. Oh, okay. So hope you understand. I'll enter. Now make a on first point, second point. Okay, now take line command again, click here. Now at 22 feet, less than key, suppose 45 D, then 15 minute and 5 seconds. Okay, so at 22 feet, 45 degree, 15 minute and 5 seconds. Another line, I am creating presenter. See, now I'll check this by mesosim command. Click here. Now click on first point here and second point here. Okay, sorry, distance. So click here again, click here. Now this is the distance 22 feet. Okay, now I check the angle. Click on angle. So click here. This is 45 degree, 15 minutes and 5 seconds. So hope you understand. Okay, so hope you understand how to use mesosim command. Now if you like this video, then don't forget to like and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.